Good morning everyone and welcome to the Morning Tales for June 22, 2019. So guys, do you know that Karnataka and Maharashtra have jointly got the GI tag for producing the Kolhapuri chappals under the Geographical Indications of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999. Actually, there is a wide-held perception that Kolhapuri chappals are only manufactured in Maharashtra, but in reality, a large number of producers also reside in Karnataka. So let's begin our morning tales for today with this first question. Which country is the fastest growing economy of Asia Pacific region according to Asian Development Bank? So there are five options: Japan, Australia, China, India, and Bangladesh. So out of these five options, it is Bangladesh which has been named as the fastest growing economy by the Asian Development Bank. So basically, Asian Development Bank or ADB has projected a growth rate of 7.9% for Bangladesh for the year 2018-19. And according to this rate, Bangladesh is the fastest growing economy in the Asia Pacific region. Apart from this, the 8% growth rate has also been predicted by ADB for Bangladesh for the upcoming year, that is 2019-2020. So this is again the highest growth rate that has been projected for Bangladesh. Now, what is the growth projections for India by the ADB? So guys, we have also made a video dedicated to the GDP projections of India. So do watch that video on the YouTube itself and mention your answers in the comment section below that what is the growth rate projections by ADB for India for the current year as well as for the upcoming year. So with this said, let's move on to the next question. Which state has launched the Sarbat Sehat Bima Yojana? So as this picture is also hinting at the answer, so the answer to this question is Punjab, which has for the first time launched a universal health insurance scheme. So this is a first of its kind scheme being launched in Punjab. And this scheme aims to cover 43.18 lakh families with a health insurance cover of rupees 5 lakh. Under these 43.18 lakh people, 14.86 lakh people are already covered under the PM Jan Arogya Yojana. So for these 14.86 lakh people, the state and central government will share the cost in the ratio of 60:40. And for the rest of the beneficiaries that are covered in this scheme, the cost will be completely borne by the state government of Punjab. So let's move on to the next question. Which Indian has been awarded with the Commonwealth Secretary General's Innovation for Sustainable Development Award 2019? So recently, during the 70th anniversary of the Commonwealth Secretary General's Innovation for Sustainable Development Awards were conferred upon the people from the various Commonwealth nations. And from India, it is the Nitish Jhangir who has been conferred the award. So now, he has been given this award for his innovation called the SANS. This SANS is a low-cost breathing device which has been devised in order to prevent the deaths of premature babies who die due to unavailability of high-tech machineries. So another important fact about this device is that it is the world's first continuous positive air pressure device which can be charged from multiple sources. For example, direct electricity or from a car battery. So let's move on to the next question. What was the population of displaced people in world in 2018 according to the Global Trends report? So this Global Trends report is released by UN High Commissioner for Refugees, and this report takes record of the displaced people in the world. So according to this report, in the year 2018, around 70.8 million people were displaced in the world. This is the largest number UNHCR has observed in almost 70 years. So this fact itself makes this number very important, that it is the highest since 70 years. Now another fact about this report is that it mentions that in the year 2018, around 13.6 million people were newly displaced. So this number means that in 2018, an average of 37,000 people were being displaced on a daily basis. So such a huge number by which the population of the world is being displaced. So do you guys know that there is also a day called World Refugee Day? that is observed to create awareness about the plight of these refugees. So this World Refugee Day is observed on June 20 every year by the UN. And what is the theme of this day? So do mention your answers in the comment section below that what was the theme of World Refugee Day. Let's move on to the next question, that is, which is the top university of India according to the QS World University Rankings 2020. So this QS World University Rankings ranks universities around the globe, and it has ranked the IIT Bombay with 152 scores as the best university for 2020, followed by IIT Delhi and IISc Bangalore. Apart from this, the overall rankings of QS World University has been topped by Massachusetts Institute of Technology. From Indian perspective, it is IIT Bombay which is the top institute or the university by this QS World University ranking. Apart from this, OP Jindal Global University has become the youngest university to enter into the list, and this university was established in the year 2009. The most important fact about this ranking is the fact that it has mentioned IIT Bombay as the top university in India. Moving on to the next question, RBI has raised the limit of collateral-free loans to MSMEs, self-help groups and Mudra loan beneficiaries from 10 lakhs to. So there are five options: 30 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 15 lakhs, 25 lakhs, 35 lakhs. Out of these options, the option B, that is 20 lakhs, is the right answer. And this limit, this appraisal in the limit has been done on the recommendation of UK Sinha Committee, which was formed in the year 2019. And the purpose for forming this UK Sinha Committee is to review the MSME sector and bring reforms in case of any loopholes if present in the existing market structure. So now the question for you guys is that when is the PM Mudra Yojana launched? Because these yojanas are very important from exam point of view. So do mention your answers in the comment section below that when was this yojana launched. So last but not the least question of the day is that when is World Sickle Cell Day observed? So this is a question for you guys. Do mention your answers in the comment section below. I am only telling you the sickle cell disease. So this sickle cell disease is a genetic disease which causes the abnormality of hemoglobin and slows down the blood flow in the body. So this day is observed by UN. So do mention your answers in the comment section that when is this day observed. Thank you so much guys for watching our video, and if you like the video, do press the subscribe button and also hit the bell icon for all the latest updates. Thank you so much for watching the video.